So the idea now is to extend the notion of length, of absolute value, to vectors. So let's depict a vector. If we talk about the magnitude of that vector, what are some things that immediately come to mind? Well, first of all, unless it's the zero vector, the vector has length. So it has some positive magnitude. So what we would want is some function that takes the vector of size m to the reals. And the kind of properties that we want are that the length of that vector, nu, is greater than zero if x is not the zero vector. So zero here is the scalar zero, and zero here represents the zero vector. And that particular condition we saw before, and that's known as this function, this norm, being positive definite. Okay. What's the next thing we say? Well, you know, it would be nice that if we scale this vector, that somehow the length of that new vector was just the length of the original vector times that scaling vector. How do we capture that? If you take a vector x and you multiply it times a scalar alpha, you would like for that length to be, well, not alpha times the length of x, because alpha could be negative. So what we want to do is say the absolute value of alpha. Now finally, we're often going to have the case where we have two vectors. Let's call this x, and we have a second vector. Let's call it y. And then the net result of adding the two vectors together, we know, is this vector right here. Now, it just seems logical that a measure of the length of x plus y should obey that it is no more than the length of x plus the length of y. So the third condition that makes this function a norm is that the size of x plus y, the direct route from here to here, is no greater than the length of x plus the length of y. Okay, and that we saw before is the triangle inequality. So recall that our absolute value function for complex numbers also obeyed these three conditions and was also a norm. So now we have a family of functions, any function that obeys these conditions right here is actually a norm, which is a function that we can use to measure the length of a vector.